just going to take one or two shots just like that, okay?
Artist Linda Kosciewicz-Fleming at work as she transforms elements of a major scientific study into the mental and physical aspects of aging into a piece of art. Using a large number of photographic images, her aim has been to capture the process of successful aging and to highlight the positive aspects of aging by working with a number of people now in their 70s who are taking part in the study being run by the University of Edinburgh. Her exhibition, entitled Transformations, Life Portraits, is based on the so-called Lothian Birth Cohort 1936. The cohort is a group of individuals who were born in 1936 and took part in the Scottish Mental Survey of 1947. Psychologists at the university have spent 6 years studying the aging of 1,091 people in the Lothian Birth Cohort 1936, now in their early 70s. The researchers have looked at a number of physical and mental functions of the group as they grow older, including memory, speed of thinking, many aspects of fitness and health, eyesight and blood composition.
I think the overriding message is that aging and aging successfully can be really sort of positive. And I also want them to kind of see, people who have done that, who express that through who they are, and to kind of use the art as a kind of motivation to change attitudes towards people who are older than themselves, but also to kind of think about what they do within their own lives and to realise that pathway to old age actually is throughout your life. So by sort of bringing through sort of sequences and showing movement, you're showing something dynamic, which is a lifespan.
The study is being overseen by Professor Ian Deary of the University of Edinburgh. Ultimately, his team at the Centre for Cognitive Ageing and Cognitive Epidemiology wants to establish why some people age better than others. He feels the study's impact and value will be wide-ranging.
In the medium and long term, I would hope, and so would my collaborating scientists on the project, that the Lothian Birth Cohort 1936 can contribute to a recipe for successful ageing. That is, we know that ageing isn't just about any one thing. We know that it's a whole range of factors, from social factors through to genetics, with lots of things in between. And what each of the cohort studies that are looking at successful ageing are trying to do is to pull out the solid, replicable factors that contribute to a successful old age. There's a lot of common wisdom, that's not a bad thing, but it's more important to show scientifically validated factors that contribute to successful ageing. And one of the interesting things that's coming out of that is that to keep a healthy mind, some part of that is also keeping a healthy body. And I think the exhibition reflects that, the relationship between the mind and the body in successful ageing.
The exhibition was held at the university's In Space Gallery and was attended by a variety of interested parties, from people in the world of arts to those working in healthcare for the elderly.
I think what is important is that we make so many generalisations about older people and ageing, and these pictures show that even within the same person there are differences. It is a salutary warning against generalising, oversimplifying. And I think that's one of the things that we need to know to understand illnesses like dementia, because there's been a lot of research carried out in recent years, but in some respects we seem to be even further away from finding a solution, a cure. And I think one of the reasons why that is we haven't recognised the differences both within people, but also in the way that the illness affects people. And therefore, we're dealing with something that's much more complicated than something we can give a diagnosis to with the name of dementia.
As for the people actually taking part in the study themselves, they've found the process both interesting and rewarding, and the vast majority of them tend to have one sentiment in common. They don't feel old.
Rightly or wrongly, I don't feel I have aged. What I don't know, and of course I'm purely a non-medical person as far as this is concerned, but I don't know whether it'll be possible to halt the aging process, whether this is something that is just a fact.
Don't you know each cloud contains pennies from heaven? You'll find your phone. fashion falling all over town. Be sure that your umbrella is upside down. Trade them for a package of sunshine and flowers. If you want the things you love, you must have showers. So when you hear it thunder, don't run under a tree.
This production is copyright, The University of Edinburgh.